Yes, sir.
Yes, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good afternoon to all of you. Let's start with our next part. Okay, yesterday we have finished the types of the interest, and today we will see about two important terminologies with their formulas and the example, which are also the points related with the time value of money. And in the previous lectures, before the yesterday also, we have studied details regarding the time value of money. And in every lecture, we are also doing the recap of that. So yes, Akash, what is the time value of money? Yes, Akash is there.
Yes, sir.
Yes. What is the time value of money? What is the definition of time value of money?
Sir, the time value of money is the idea that money available at the present time. Is worth than the same amount in future due to its potential earning capacity.
Okay, so that part also we are recapping every time, because it's very important to understand the definition, you know, to understand the next part and the part that we are studying. So if you just, the definition that Akash has told me, if you just try to put that definition in the some example way, like suppose what he said, the money available today, for example, money available today is the 10,000. Okay, this is available today with somebody, is more valuable than same amount of money, in the sense it is, this 10,000 is more valuable than same amount of money, in the sense this 10,000, which will be available, for example, after the, which will be available, for example, after the 2 years. What? Money which is available today, for example, 10,000, this is more valuable than same amount of money which will be available in the future. In the future, in the sense, after the 2 years. And what are the reason behind that? Reasons we have discussed. Why this money available today is more valuable than this 10,000? Why this 10,000 is more valuable than this 10,000 that you are going to get after the 2 years? What is the main reason behind that?
Risk and uncertainty.
Risk, uncertainty, others, which you consider to be the primary reason, that is what?
Investment.
Investment, exactly. Okay. So this thing, if you just this keep this thing in mind, you can easily explain the time value of money, and other examples also we have discussed during the previous lecture and the lecture which is the previous to the yesterday lecture that we have discussed. And today we are going to discuss the in details time value, the future value, which is the important concept related to the time value, that is the future value. Here I have written the definition. Okay, and in the first lecture of the time value of money also, in short, I have explained you what is the future value. So here, if you see the definition, you can read it. A sum of money invested today at compound interest accumulates to a larger sum called as the future value. Now, yesterday we have seen the concept of the compounding. Okay, what is the compounding? Yes. What is the compounding?
Principal amount plus previous time period sum interest.
Yes. So if you compare the simple interest and the compounding interest, so compounding nothing but what? When we are calculating the interest, we are not just taking in consideration the principal amount, but we are considering the principal amount plus interest, and on that whole amount, who is to calculate the further interest. Okay. So the future value is nothing but what? For example, here I have mentioned the sample example that last time also we have discussed. For example, if yes, if rupees 1 invested at 8% today, can you able to see this properly? If rupees 1 invested at 8% today to become 1.08 in the future, what, how much you have invested today? Rupees 1 at which interest rate? Interest rate of
8%.
Now, how after, for example, just after the 1 year, how much it is becoming?
1.08
means which is the future value year and which is the future value year?
1.08
is nothing but your future value of some present amount 1. Now, how it has increased to the 1.08 from 1? Yes, how it has increased from 1 to 1.08?
Sir, interest add that
because of the interest. And what interest? Compound interest. Understood. So this is the definition. A sum of money invested today, for example, sum of money 1 rupees you have invested today, at which interest? Compound interest, accumulates to a larger sum 1.08 sum, that is called as the future value. This also, you can see the example that yesterday already we have seen. The future value of rupees 1000 invested at 6% compounded annually for 1 year is how much? 1060. Okay. So whatever the amount you invest today, the amount that you will get from that amount invested today in the future, that future amount is called as what? The future value of some present amount. Okay. So that is the reason here I have mentioned the future value consists of what? Compounding. Compounding in the sense, when you are calculating the future value, we are not just taking in the consideration the principal amount, but we are considering the principal amount plus interest. So future value consists of the compounding, where we add interest in the principal to calculate the interest for subsequent period and get the return on the investment. Okay. So if I ask you, the future value depends on what? Future value depends on what? Yes.
Principal
amount, then
plus interest.
Interest, then
time period.
Number of period, and most importantly, the I expect
compounding.
Compounding frequency.
Compounding.
Good, Suraj. Compounding frequency. So here, just as I mentioned, the future value of rupees 1000 invested at 6% compounded annually for 1 year is 1060. Apan kal don example baghitle baka compounding madhe. Ek first we have seen as a annual compounding. Dar 1000 tumhi invest kele at an interest rate of 6% ani compounding kashi keli annually, tar hi 1000 chi kimmat kiti hote after 1 year? Yes. What will be the future value of 1000 invested at 6% compounded annually? After 1 year, it is becoming how much? 1060. Barabar. But if you invest the same amount, 1000, at 6% at the same interest rate, but compounded quarterly for 1 year, then how much it is becoming? How much this 1000 is becoming if you compound it quarterly? How much it is becoming?
1061.37.
So 1061.37. Understood. That is the reason here I have mentioned the future value varies, means future value get changed with the interest rate. If this 6% get changed as a 8%, then definitely your future value will change or not?
Yes,
change. Also, if instead of compounding annually, I said compound it monthly, then also your future value change or not?
Yes, change.
So that is the point you should keep in mind. The future value varies or change with the interest rate, compounding frequency and the number of periods. These are the some basic characteristic related with the future value. Now here we are going to see the how to generate the formula for the future value. Okay, on which the in the exam question being asked, numerical exams on the for future value, in which you have to utilize some formula and calculate the future value. Okay. So we are going to generate the formula first and then we see the example on that. Okay. Now in order to generate the formula for future value of any amount, we want the formula for future value of any amount. To generate that formula, first we'll generate the formula for future values of rupees 1. What? First we generate the formula for future values of rupees 1, and then from that formula of future values of rupees 1, will generate the formula for future value of any amount. Okay, getting? Let's see. If the future values of rupees 1 principal is invested is known, then we can use it to calculate the future value of any amount invested. So what I want to say, first we need to generate the formula for future values of rupees 1. If you get that, we can utilize that formula and we can generate the formula for future values of any amount. So let's see. So here we are given the table, and from this table we will generate the formula. This table is given, okay, as an example, at 8% interest per period, rupees 1 is accumulated as follow. At which interest rate? 8%. Which principal amount? What is the principal amount in this example?
1 rupees.
Rupees 1. So at 8% per period, rupees 1 accumulated as follow. So here table, readymade table we have given, and we use that table to generate the formula. So future values of rupees 1 at 8% for one period. Future values of rupees 1 at 8% for one period. It is given as this. What is given? 1.00 multiplied by 1.08. Now from where this 1.08 comes? Yes.
Principal value plus interest. 8%.
So this is the principal. 1. From where this value comes? From where this value comes? This 1.08. I hope all of you are having the calci. Yes, from where this value comes. Now, our interest rate is how much? 8%. If you convert that 8% into the decimal, how much it will become? 0.08. For how many periods you are accumulating or you are calculating?
One period.
Manje kai 0.08 plus 1. And that will give it how much? 1.08. Getting? Yes?
Yes, sir.
And in this way, I'm just telling you how this ready-made table is formed. Okay, so in this way, you get here 1.0800. Now, if you go for the future values of rupees 1 at 8% for 2 period, so this is being calculated in this way, 1.0800. Now, in the previous row, our principal was how much? 1 only. Now, next row, our principal now become how much? 1.08 for next period. Getting?
Yes, sir.
And we multiply it by the 1.08. Every time we are going to multiply by the 1.08, you can see. And this, after this, we get this amount. Again, if you go for the future values of rupees 1 at 8% for three period, so this amount will become your principal amount in the next period, for third period. And again, you multiply it by the 1.08. And in this way, you will get the this amount as a... Now, this will carry on. If you go on doing this, this will carry on. Only the things we have to take out from this table is to generate the formula for future values of rupees 1. Now, from this table, so from above scenario, we have general formula for future values of rupees 1 with n representing the number of corresponding period is this. So this is the future, this is the formula for future. Now this, okay, this n must be here. Okay, this n must be here. This is the formula. So this is the formula for future values of rupees 1, where n is what? N representing the number of period. Okay, now what is the formula? 1 plus I into n. What is the formula? 1 plus I into n. Okay. So this formula as a formula for the future values of rupees 1. This is also called as factor for the future values of rupees 1. What it is called? Factor for the future values of rupees 1. Okay. Now do you got how we have got this 1 plus I raised to n? Yes. From this part we have got this. From this part. Yes or no? Every time what we are doing to the period 1, we are adding the interest, that is the 0.08. Correct?
Yes, sir.
That is the reason what we have written here 1. This is 0.08 is what?
Interest.
Interest. Manun apan ita kai getla I. बरोबर
यस सर
आणि त्याला रेस टू काय केलं
एन
एन एन का एन ने का रेस टू केलं कारण आपल्याला फॉर हाऊ मेनी पीरियड वी वॉन्ट टू कॅल्क्युलेट येस ऑर नो
यस सर
एन रिप्रेझेंट व्हॉट फॉर नंबर ऑफ पीरियड्स यू वॉन्ट टू कॅल्क्युलेट दॅट पर्टिक्युलर फ्युचर व्हॅल्यू फॉर रुपीज 1 अंडरस्टूड Now, using this factor for the future values of rupees 1, using this formula, what we can do, we are going to calculate the formula for future values of any rupees for any interest and for any time period. So here I have mentioned, to calculate the future value of any principal other than rupees 1, we multiply the principal by factor for the future values of rupees 1. What we do to calculate the future value of any principal other than rupees 1, we multiply what by what? We multiply principal by factor for the future values of rupees 1. So that from that we'll get this formula for future values of any amount. So future value equal to what? P into F, where P stands for what?
Principal
and F stands for what?
Factor
for the future values of rupees
1.
Now let's compare this formula with this table and tell me whether this formula is correct or not. What we are doing every time here, we are multiplying, what is this 1.00?
Principal.
So that's why what we have taken here P, correct?
Yes, sir.
And you are multiplying it by what? This part. What is this part?
Time period plus interest.
That is the factor for the future values of rupees 1. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And that's why you have written here F. So in this formula, that is what? Future value is equal to P into F, where F is what? Factor for the future values of rupees 1. Getting?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is nothing but the formula for future values of rupees 1. Okay. Now let's see the example for future value. Okay. Now, when we are developing this formula, you can easily see every time we are adding the interest, we are trying to multiply the principal by the interest. Yes or no? Every time you can see this part, correct?
Yes, sir.
Why this is so? Because in case of the future value, we are utilizing the compounding. That is the reason every time we are trying to add or we are trying to multiply the principal by the sum interest and the period. Okay. Now let's see the example for the future value. If you have a notebook, you can write it down shortly. XYZ company invest rupees 40 lakh in certificates of deposit that earn 16% interest per year, compounded semi-annually. What will be the future value of investment at the end of 5 years when the company plans to use it to build the new plant? What you are understanding from this example? Yes. XYZ company is doing what?
Invest karte.
Kiti amount? 40 lakhs. Barobar?
Yes.
Ki ani interest rate ka hai?
16%
per year. Compounding kasa honare?
Semi annually.
तर मग फ्युचर व्हॅल्यू काय कुठल्या याची ही जी अमाऊंट आहे या अमाऊंटची फ्युचर व्हॅल्यू व्हॉट इज द फ्युचर व्हॅल्यू ऑफ दिस अमाऊंट 40 लाख कधी ऍट द एंड ऑफ फाईव्ह इयर्स आणि XYZ कंपनी कशासाठी इन्व्हेस्ट करते XYZ कंपनीला काय करायचंय भविष्यात एक नवीन प्लांट उभा करायचा बरोबर
यस सर
सो let's solve it so compounding is semi annual and there are the time period of how much 5 years time period is how much 5 years correct so if the compounding is semi annual what will be the value of your n
10
exactly so this is n equal to 10 now interest rate is given as what 16% per year barobar As you can see, the compounding is happening semi-annually. Then what will be your interest rate?
8%.
8%. The same thing I have mentioned. The semi-annual interest rate is half the 16%. And that is the reason we have the 8% for semi-annual. Now, let's see what is our formula future value equal to P into F. Barobar? We already know what is the P. P equal to how much?
14 lakhs.
Correct. Now, yes, what sir. You have to find out F. F stands for what year? In the future value one formula. F is what?
1 plus I.
Means it is a factor for the future value. Barobar?
Yes, sir.
And its formula is what? 1 plus I raised to N. Barobar?
Yes, sir.
Now, first you need to find out this. First you need to find out the factor for the future value. So, find out the 1 plus I raised to N. And tell me the value. Tell me the value of F. Factor for the future value. So what, how I, value you have to put like this? 1 plus I is how much? This is I. 0.08. This is I. I is 0.08. Correct.
0.08.
Raise to?
10
raised to 10. 10 and now calculate it with calci
2.15
so it must 2. Be 2.15 correct multiply it by the principal amount How much?
86,35,680.
So this is okay?
Yes, sir.
So this is nothing but the future value of amount 40 lakh. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Understood the future value?
Yes sir. Yes, sir.
So let's move forward to the present value. Okay. So the thing we have to keep in mind regarding the future value is what? In the future value, it consists of the compounding. Okay. Where we add the interest to the principal to calculate the interest for subsequent period and get the return on investment. Okay. So let's see the present value. So present, already in the first lecture of time value of money also we have discussed the present value. So it is the value of the money in the today's term. Value of money today for some future value of money. Present value is the current value of future sum of the money. Let's see the example here and you can understand easily. If rupees 1 is invested at 8% today to become 1.08 in the future. Now, one thing you should keep in mind, present value is the exact opposite of what? Future value. Correct?
Yes, sir.
So, in the similar example, we can carry, if rupees 1 is invested at 8% today to become 1.08 in the future, then rupees 1 is what? Present value or the future value?
Present
value.
Rupees 1 is nothing present but value. What? Present value. For the present future value. Amount of sum 1.08. Okay. So, am I clearly audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this present value is generally utilized in the business decision makings. Okay. Am I clearly audible or breaking sound? Hello?
Break hota hai sir, madhe.
Clear, sir.
Okay, so the present value for what, if you ask me for what purpose the present value is utilized, so present value generally utilized in the business decision makings, and it is for what purpose? It is generally for the purpose of knowing the future receipt of the money. Means what exactly? Suppose, here I have mentioned, suppose for what purpose the present value is being utilized, it is necessary to decide how much future receipts are worth in order to determine whether an investment should be made or not and how much should be the investment to be made. Means what? Ki tumhala, if you know, after 10 years, you are going to get 10 lakh rupees. After 10 years, how much you are going to get? 10 lakh rupees. Okay, so this is your future receipt. Yes or no? Correct?
Yes, sir.
Now, if I ask you, this 10 lakh rupees you are going to get after the 10 years, can you tell me what is its value today? If I am asking you the 10 lakh rupees that you are going to get after 10 years, what is its value today? Means what? What is the value of future receipt in the today's term. Is it like that? Yes or no? Because if you know what is the present value of this 10 lakh rupees that you are going to get after 10 years, then according to that, you can make changes in your investment. Yes or no? If you want 12 lakh rupees, how much? 12 lakh rupees after the 10 years. Then how much amount to be invest today? How you will decide? Yes, you are getting the situation. What I am asking you. How much amount you want after the 10 year? 10 lakhs or the 12 lakhs, correct?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Then can you answer me how much today we have to invest for that? जर तुम्हाला 10 वर्षानंतर 10 लाख किंवा 12 लाख अमाउंट पाहिजे असेल तर त्याच्यासाठी तुम्हाला आज काहीतरी इन्व्हेस्टमेंट करावं लागेल की नाही?
Yes, sir.
बरोबर. आणि मग हे सो टू फाइंड आउट how much you should invest today. So to find out that, there is a utilization of present value. Got the point?
Yes, sir.
Barobar na, jar tumhala 10 varshanantar 10 lakh kiwa 12 lakh rupaye paije astil, tar tyachyasathi tumhala he maiti asna garjeche aahe ki tar he je 10 lakh 12 lakh tumhala paije astil 10 varshanantar, tar tyachyasathi tumhala aaj kiti amount invest karavi lagel. Ani te find out karnyasathi kay use kele jate? Present value. Got the point?
Yes, yes, sir.
And that is the reason I have mentioned here. It is necessary to decide how much future receipts are worth today in order to determine whether an investment should be made or how much should be invested. Okay, got the point? And similarly, for example, if some XYZ company want 5 lakh rupees after the 5 years, how much that XYZ company must invest today at the present time? To find out these kind of things, there is a utilization of what? There is a utilization of present value concept. Getting?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, the way in case of future value we have seen, the future value consists of what? It is based on which technique? Are we calculating the interest in the simple way? In the future value, in order to calculate the future value? What kind of interest we are utilizing there? Simple?
Compounding.
Compounding. Compound interest we are utilizing in what? In order to calculate the future value. That is the reason I told you future value consists of what? Compounding. Okay. And as I said, the present value is the opposite of future value. And in case of, that is the reason, in case of the present value consists of discounting. Now, what do you mean by the discounting then? Can you tell me the difference between the compounding and the discounting from the part we have studied? Yes. As I said, future value is opposite to the present value. Future value calculation consists of the compounding, where present value consists of the discounting. So what do you mean by this, compounding versus discounting?
Discounting madhe sir jevda percent ne dilela ase tevda decrease karayche
value. Decrease karayche, very good. कारण मी काय म्हटलं की फ्युचर व्हॅल्यू इज अपोजिट टू द प्रेझेंट व्हॅल्यू और प्रेझेंट व्हॅल्यू इज अपोजिट टू द फ्युचर व्हॅल्यू तर फ्युचर व्हॅल्यू मध्ये आपण काय करतो वी गो ऑन ऍडिंग द इंटरेस्ट टू द प्रिन्सिपल येस ऑर नो
येस सर
ऍडिंग इन द सेन्स मल्टीप्लाइंग यू कॅन से इट ऍडिंग ऑर द मल्टीप्लाइंग यू हॅव टू जस्ट कीप इन माइंड की इफ यू डू द कंपाउंडिंग युअर your principal is going to be increased because of addition of the interest plus the principal amount. But in case of the discounting, what is happening? Here I have mentioned present value consists of the discounting where we deduct or minus the interest from the principal to calculate the interest for subsequent period and get the return on the investment. And you can see the same kind of thing I have written here in case of future value, where you can see the future value consists of the compounding where we add interest in the principal to calculate the interest for subsequent period and get the return on investment. Here we are adding, okay. And when you go to the present value, you can see here what we are doing here. Present value consists of discounting where we deduct or minus the interest from the principal to calculate the interest for subsequent period and get the return on investment. Now, getting the meaning of discounting?
Yes, sir.
Exactly opposite to the compounding. In the compounding, we go on adding the interest, adding in the sense multiplying. And in case of the discounting, we are go on deducting or minusing the interest for certain period. Okay, that is nothing but the here I have mentioned. Discounting is opposite of the compounding, where compounding calculate the increase in the amount of money earned. Yes or no? Compounding is this. Compounding calculate the increase in the amount of money earned. Yes or no? Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
And discounting does what? Discounting calculate the decrease in the amount of money earned over the time. Because, as I said, present value is the opposite to the future value. Future value definition is what? Future value is what? Amount that you are going to get in the future for the amount that you have invested today. But the present value is what? Present value is nothing but calculating the amount of some future value in today's term. Okay, so that is nothing but the difference here between the future value and the present value, and the techniques utilized in that. In the future value, utilize the compounding. In the present value, utilize the discounting. So finding the present value of future receipt or future value involve finding the present value of future receipt or future value involves the discounting. We need to discount the future value to the present. What we have to do, we have to discount the present value to the future value to the present. So in order to understand this discounting concept, you can simply take this example. I am trying to make it slightly easy for you. Now you must have heard about sometimes the cloth merchants manje kon cloth merchants, what is the meaning of cloth merchant? कपड्याचे ते व्यापारी असतात बघा. ओके, फॉर दॅट वी युटिलाइज द वर्ड क्लोथ मर्चंट. तुम्ही बघितलं असेल बऱ्याच वेळेस हे कपड्याचे दुकानदार काय बऱ्याच वेळेस ते तुम्हाला सेल ऑफर करतात, बरोबर?
Yes.
सेल किंवा आपण त्याला Yes, all of you are there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let's try to understand the discounting with better example. Okay, real life example. तर हे जे कपड्याचे व्यापारी असतात ते बऱ्याच वेळेस काय ऑफर करतात बघा, तुम्हाला सेल किंवा कपड्यावर डिस्काउंट ऑफर करतात, बरोबर?
करेक्ट.
काय व्हाय दे डू दिस? त्यांच्याकडे ह्या ज्या व्यापाऱ्याकडे जे कपडे असणार आहे, बरोबर, तर ते कधीतरी फ्युचर मध्ये विकले जाणार असा त्याचा अंदाज आहे, बरोबर? करेक्ट. मग हे जर फ्युचर मध्ये विकले जाणार असतील तर कन्सिडर करा की एक हे काहीतरी कपड्याचे ब्रँड आहेत, त्याची किंमत किती आहे? 1000. किती आहे? 1000, बरोबर. आता हे कपडे कधीतरी फ्युचर मध्ये विकले जाणार आहेत बऱ्यापैकी, बरोबर? काय, ठीक आहे. तर ते कितीला विकले जाणार आहेत? ऑन ऍट विच प्राइस दे आर गोइंग टू बी सेल? ऍट द 1000 रुपीज, बरोबर? बट हियर दॅट क्लोथ मर्चंट इज हॅव्हिंग सम डाऊट इन हिज माइंड की हे जे प्रोडक्ट 1000 तुम्ही विकणार आहे किंवा हे जे तुम्ही जो कपड्याचा ब्रँड असेल तो 1000 जो विकणार आहे तुम्ही फ्युचरमध्ये किंवा आता एक दिवसानंतर दोन दिवस किंवा जे काही इफ इफ द प्रोडक्ट गेट सेल इन द टुमारो डे आफ्टर टुमारो दॅट ट्रेड ऑल्सो कन्सिडर एज अ फ्युचर इफ दिस इज गोइंग टू बी सेल इन द फ्युचर फॉर 1000 रुपीज बट दॅट मर्चंट इज हॅव्हिंग द डाऊट इन हिज माइंड की सेम क्वालिटीचे कपडे दुसरा कुठला तरी एक एक्स वाय झेड दुकानदार सुद्धा लॉन्च करणार आहे की त्याच्याकडे सुद्धा ते कपडे काय काय येणार आहेत विक्रीसाठी येणार आहे करेक्ट देन व्हॉट यू डू देन सो थिंग कम्स इन हिज माइंड वाय शुड नॉट वी सेल दिस ट्राय टू सेल दिस क्लोथ टुडे ओनली जे कपडे तो फ्युचरमध्ये विकणार होता बरोबर तर त्याच्यामध्ये एक शंका आली की जर दुसऱ्या कुणीतरी व्यापाऱ्यांनी तेच कपडे त्याच्याकडे असेल तर ह्या ह्या दुकानदाराकडे जे कपडे आहेत आपण याला एबीसी म्हणू थोडक्यात एबीसी बरोबर आणि दुसरा त्याचा कॉम्पिटिटर आपण त्याला काय म्हटलं एक्स वाय झेड ह्या फ्युचर ह्या हे जे त्याचे कपडे आहेत त्याच्याकडे याचा याची प्राइस फ्युचरमध्ये त्याला किती मिळणार होती 1000 पण त्याच्या मनात एक भीती निर्माण झाली किंवा दुसऱ्या कोण दुसऱ्या दुकानदार दुकानाकडे जर असेच ब्रँडचे कपडे असतील बरोबर आता बऱ्याच दुकानमध्ये असतात असे तर ही माइट नॉट एबल टू सेल दिस प्रोडक्ट इन द फ्युचर ऍट 1000 रुपीज येस ऑर नो ऍट ही माइट नॉट एबल टू सेल ऑल हिज प्रोडक्ट इन द फ्युचर अंडरस्टूड सो व्हॉट ही विल डू नाव ही विल ट्राय टू सेल इट टुडे ओके maximum amount of item he will try to sell today yes or no
yes sir
now tala bhavishyamade kiti milnar hote tya eka item chi price 1000 barobar
yes sir
pan tyanni kay decide kela ki ata apan he aajas vikaycha prayatna karu mhanje current period madhe apan te vikaycha prayatna karu barobar mag jar current period madhe tyala vikaycha astil te तर त्याला हे एक 1000 विकता कॅन ही युटिलाइज दिस सेम प्राइस और विल ही ऑफर सम डिस्काउंटेड प्राइस टू द कस्टमर सो दॅट सेल कॅन बी इन्क्रीज
डिस्काउंट दिलं तर सेल इन्क्रीज होईल सर
त्याला काय करावं लागेल डिस्काउंट द्यावा लागेल एम आय राईट ऑर नॉट अंडरस्टूड मग आता हे भविष्यामध्ये जर ते त्याला 1000 विकणार असेल तू तर पण त्याला भविष्यामध्ये न विकता तर आजच त्याला मॅक्सिमम सेल करायचा असेल तर तो त्याची प्राइस किती करू शकतो 1100 करेल का
नाही सर
मग त्याला काय करावं लागेल 900 किंवा 950 विच विल बी लेसर दॅन दिस एम आय राईट ऑर नॉट
यस सर
अँड दिस पर्टिक्युलर अमाउंट विच अमाउंट दिस 900 और दिस 950 is nothing but the present value of this 1000 am I right
yes sir
what is happening here compounding or the discounting exactly getting the point
yes sir
so that is the concept of the discounting with the help of which the present value is get determined Now, way we have generated the formula for the future value, in the similar way, we will try to generate the formula for present value. Okay? So, knowing the present value of rupees 1 is useful because using that, we can find the present value of any future amount. In the similar way, just like in the future value, in order to generate the formula for future value of any amount, first we have generated the formula for future value of rupees 1. In the similar way, here we will try to generate first the formula for present value of rupees 1 and using that formula for present value of rupees 1 we will generate the formula for present value of any formula for present value of any amount okay so you can see here we will carry the same example assuming the 8% interest per year a table of present values of rupees 1 is constructed as follow this is the table okay So here you can see the present values of rupees 1. Ata ita kay mhatle baka discounted for one period at 8% is this. What is being done here? Increasement or the decreasement?
डिक्रिमेंट
डिक्रिमेंट आपण आपण फ्युचर व्हॅल्यू करताना काय केलं होतं मल्टिप्लाय केलं होतं हिअर व्हॉट वी आर डुईंग वी आर डिवायडिंग करेक्ट ऑर नॉट
येस सर
अँड हिअर यू विल गेट द प्रिन्सिपल अमाऊंट फ्युचर व्हॅल्यू मध्ये आपलं काय होतं प्रिन्सिपल अमाऊंट स्टेप बाय स्टेप आपली वाढत होती इथं डिक्रीज होत जाणार आहे बघा तुम्ही ओके सो नेक्स्ट प्रेझेंट व्हॅल्यू ऑफ रुपीज वन डिस्काउंटेड फॉर टू पिरियड ऍट द 8% सो दिस प्रिन्सिपल अमाऊंट यू हॅव टू युटिलाइज फॉर द नेक्स्ट पिरियड डिवाइडेड बाय 1.08 अँड यू विल गेट दिस अगेन दिस अमाऊंट यू हॅव टू युटिलाइज फॉर द थर्ड पिरियड ऍज अ प्रिन्सिपल दिस डिवाइड बाय 1.08 अँड गेट दिस हाऊ दिस 1.08 हॅज गॉट in the similar way that last time I have shown okay 1 plus 0.08 so from this table from this above scenario we have general formula for the present values of rupees 1 with n representing the number of corresponding period is this getting why this 1 Yes. Because we are calculating for the rupees 1 only. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So this is the PR factor for the present value of rupees 1. And what is that? That is nothing but 1 divided by 1 plus I raised to n. What? 1 divided by 1 plus I raised to n. What is this 1?
Time period.
I interest and n for corresponding corresponding time period. Okay, this particular now we can see here how we have generated this. This we have generated like this 1 plus 0.08. Getting so this one is nothing but the our particular one period. Understood. Now if you want to find it for any period, then we have to do it as a raised to n. Getting? Aplyal jar kutlyahi period sathi karava lagat asel karayla lagel. If you want to calculate it for any period, then this n represent the any amount of period. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
एकाच पिरियड साठी करायचं असेल तर म्हणून इथं 1 म्हटलंय करेक्ट गेटिंग द डिफरन्स बिटवीन धिस 1 अँड धिस 1 यस धिस 1 अँड धिस 1 धिस 1 रिप्रेझेंट वॉट Yes, this one represent what?
Principal value.
Principal. And this one for just
time period.
One time period. And n kashyasathi, if you want to find it for any time period, then we have to utilize the n. Okay. Now using this factor for the present value. To calculate the present value for any future amount. आता ही फक्त एका रुपयासाठीची हा फॉर्म्युला फक्त कुठल्यासाठी आहे एका रुपयासाठी पण आपल्याला काय पाहिजे एका रुपयासाठी पाहिजे का आपल्याला फॉर्म्युला
नो
वी वॉन्ट द फॉर्म्युला फॉर एनी अमाउंट सो टू कॅल्क्युलेट द प्रेझेंट व्हॅल्यू ऑफ एनी फ्युचर अमाऊंट अदर दॅन द रुपीज 1 वी मल्टीप्लाय the principal by factor for the present values of rupees 1 what we do we multiply what by what we multiply the principal by the factor for the present values of rupees 1 and that is the reason I have mentioned this formula here present value equal to principal into what pr where pr stands for what
factor for the present value
of rupees 1 and using this formula we can find out the present values of rupees any amount okay got the how the formula comes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's see the example. Now this is the example which is being asked number of times in the exam also, in the exam also for 8 marks. Alpha company can invest at 16% compounded annually. Beta company can invest at 16% compounded semi-annually. Okay. Each company will need 2 lakh rupees 4 years from now. How much investment each company must do today? Yes. What is the example? First understand the example. Yes, what is the example? There are Alpha. The two companies. One is the Alpha company, other is the Beta company. Now both of these company can invest 16%, but Alpha company is investing at 16%. Compounding happening is how year? Annually. Beta company is investing 16%. Compounding happening is how year? Semi-annually. आता हे कशासाठी इन्व्हेस्टमेंट करता या दोन्ही कंपनी? व्हॉट इज द रीझन बिहाइंड दॅट?
2 लाख रुपये पाहिजे 4 वर्षांनी.
त्यांना काय काय पाहिजेत की 2 वर्षानंतर त्यांना, सॉरी, 4 वर्षानंतर त्यांना काय 2 लाख अमाऊंट दे वॉन्ट. मग त्याच्यासाठी त्यांना आज किती इन्व्हेस्टमेंट करावी लागेल? बरोबर गेटिंग?
Yes, sir.
Now how we can find out it? By using the which formula? Future value formula or the present value formula?
Present value formula.
Present value formula. Now let's see the with the annual, other let's see for the Alpha company with the annual compounding. Now related with the Alpha company, what is the value of n, what is the value of I?
N is in 4, sir.
N4 असणार, कारण कंपाउंडिंग कसं होतंय अल्फाचं?
अन्युअली.
आणि इंटरेस्ट रेट सुद्धा काय असणार? 16%, कारण कंपाउंडिंग कसं होतंय? अन्युअली. बीटा, दिस इज फॉर द अल्फा, दिस इज फॉर द बीटा. नाव रिलेटेड विथ द बीटा, कंपाउंडिंग इज हॅपनिंग हाऊ? सेमी अन्युअली. सो व्हॉट विल बी द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ एन? एन विल बी, बरोबर ना, 8 ना, बरोबर ना, 4 इयर्स आहेत ना, 4 इयर्स आहेत. जर सेमी अन्युअल कंपाउंडिंग होणार असेल, सो 4 विल बी, दिस 4 विल बिकम 8, करेक्ट?
येस सर.
अँड व्हॉट विल बी द आय?
8%.
बरोबर, अन्युअली आय किती आहे? 16%. पण बीटा कंपनीचं कंपाउंडिंग कसं होतं? सेमी अन्युअली. That's why it will become 8%. Now using the above formula, we can find the present value of Alpha company as follows. First we find present value for Alpha, and then we will find the present value for Beta. Now what is the formula we are having? Principal into PR. Now related with the Alpha company, we know the principal. That is how much? 2 lakhs. What you need to find out? You need to find out the PR, present value factor. Now find out the present value factor. Now what is the formula for present value factor? Yes, what is the formula for present value factor?
One divided by 1 plus I raised to n.
Okay, then find out. वन प्लस आय किती आहे? वन प्लस आय विल बी वन प्लस आय इज हाऊ मच 16% म्हणजे वन प्लस 0.16 बरोबर इट विल बिकम हाऊ मच 1.16 सो 1 डिवाइडेड बाय 1.16 रेस टू एन डू द कॅल्क्युलेशन Yes, are you doing the calculation? How much it is coming? इथं रेस टू इथं 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 काय पाहिजे हिअर आय हॅव मिस समथिंग इथं काय पाहिजे
रेस टू फोर
हा बरोबर आहे
Oh.
Yes, sir.
Then what present value will get? Is this like this? Are you getting this?
So,
1,10,458. Barobar na?
Oh.
What is its meaning? Jar Alpha company la 4 varshanantar 2 lakh rupaye paije astil, tar current period la tyanna kiti amount invest karava lagel? Got these things regarding the Alpha company. Now find out the regarding the Beta company and tell me. Find out for the Beta company. Are you solving? Are you calculating or shall we go forward? Calculate karta hai ka?
Ho.
Okay. How much the present value for Beta company is coming? बरोबर अल्फा कंपनीची किती येत होती 1,10,000 समथिंग बरोबर प्रेझेंट व्हॅल्यू बीटा कंपनीला किती येते 1,08,000 समथिंग वाय दिस इज सो बोथ द कंपनीज यू कॅन सी दिअर इफ यू सी द एक्झाम्पल अल्फा is also investing at 16%. Beta also investing at the 16%. Then why Alpha company need to invest more as compared with the Beta company?
Sir, tense compounding annually, sir.
Kunacha?
Alpha company, sir.
Yes. The Alpha company compounding is annually, but Beta company compounding is what? Semi-annually. And that is the reason Beta company has to invest less as compared with the Alpha company. Understood?
Yes, sir.
The same thing I have mentioned from the above example, we can conclude that more frequent the compounding, smaller the present value. Yes or no? Is it correct? More frequent the compounding, smaller the present value. Beta company need to invest less than the alpha company because investment of beta company grows faster due to the frequent compounding or repetitive compounding. So that is nothing but the present value. Okay, on these two concept, the present value and the future value, number of times question being asked in the numerical way. Okay, so for that you have to keep in mind these formulas, formula for present future value and formula for the present value. Okay, yes, understood the both the point, future value and the present value?
Yes sir.
Okay, now let's see the another important concept on which the 2 marks question can be asked, that is the annuity. Okay, annuity. Now before we go to the theoretical definition of the annuity, let me tell you the example, so that example will make it more easy. How many of you are having your LIC policies? Is there anybody who are having their policies of LIC? Or is there anybody who are having their home, they are paying the EMIs for their house, car? Yes. Do anybody is having the LIC policy?
LIC sir.
LIC. Kiti ji tuji?
Sir, 2 lakh ji.
2 lakh ji. What is the time period? किती वर्षानंतर मिळणार? मॅच्युरिटी पिरियड काय
सर? 2034 ला मिळणार.
2034 ला होणार आहे. तू किती अमाऊंट पे करतो?
600 रुपये 6 महिन्याला.
सो फॉर सम फ्युचर व्हॅल्यू दॅट इज द 2 लाख रुपीज, करेक्ट? You are paying 600 rupees for every 6 months, correct? Yes. Is this your situation?
Yes sir.
So you are making the series of equal payment. Now when you have started,
स्टार्ट केली होती नाही सर, वडिलांनीच काढली होती सर.
बर, पण मग किती वर्षासाठी? किती वर्षासाठी असं? 15 इयर्स फॉर एक्झाम्पल, वी कन्सिडर इट ॲज अ 15 इयर्स, करेक्ट?
येस सर.
मीन्स यू आर गोइंग टू मेक दीज 600 रुपीज इक्वल पेमेंट for next 15 years continuously. Yes or no?
Yes sir.
Now 600 per 6 months, if you consider, so for 1 year 600, it will be the 1200, barobar 1200. If you yes, multiply sir. The 1200 by 15, how much it is coming? Calculate.
15,000. 18,000.
No, 1200 into 15.
18,000
कशी येईल आकाश?
1,80,000.
1,80,000 पण तुला मिळणार किती आहेत?
2 लाख.
मग ते 20,000 कुठून आले? that 20,000 is coming because of what? Compounding. Am I right or not?
Yes, sir.
You are going to get some interest on what? You are going to get some interest on that equal amount, that equal payment you are making for every 6 months. Correct or not?
Yes, sir.
If you make it 600 for first 6 months, then again 600 for next 6 months. So this 600 plus 600, it will become 1200. And again, you will going to get the interest on this 1200. It will go and adding this amount. And in this way, your total investment that you are going to make. Now, are you making this total investment at the same time? हे जे 180,000 जे होतात तुझे तू एकाच वेळेस पे करतोय का?
नो सर.
यू आर पेइंग इट एज अ सीरीज ऑफ इक्वल पेमेंट्स. इज इट करेक्ट?
येस सर.
अँड आफ्टर दॅट यू आर गोइंग टू गेट सम अमाउंट इन द फ्युचर. अँड दिस पर्टिक्युलर कन्सेप्ट ऑफ पेइंग द सीरीज ऑफ इक्वल पेमेंट ऍट इक्वल टाइम इंटरवल, that is called as what? The annuity. The same part I have written here. And annuity is series of equal payments made at equal time interval. Kutla equal time interval la tu payment kartoy? You are paying at equal time interval or not? Yes. You are paying at the equal time interval or random interval?
Equal time interval, sir.
Pratyek 6 mahinyanantar tu bharnar aahe na hafte?
Yes, sir.
That we can call it as a equal time interval or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So annuity is what? The series of equal payments made at equal time interval with compounding or discounting taking at the time of each payment. Now, in case of you, compounding is taking place or the discounting is taking place?
Compounding
is taking place, and that is called as what? The annuity. All of you are getting? Yes, Tejas. All of you got the concept of annuity?
Yes, sir.
Yes, other student? Bornare Vaishali?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, हे जे इक्वल पेमेंट आकाश करतोय दॅट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड ॲज अ रेंट ऑल्सो. दॅट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड ॲज वॉट? इच अन्युटी पेमेंट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड ॲज अ रेंट ऑल्सो. ओके. सो देर आर सेवरल टाइप्स ऑफ द अन्युटी, आउट ऑफ विच इन एन ऑर्डर इन एन द एक्झाम्पल दॅट वी हॅव डिस्कस लाईक द एल आय सी पॉलिसी, द पेमेंट विच द इक्वल पेमेंट विच इज मेड देअर दॅट इज ऑल्सो रिफर्ड ॲज अ rent. So there are the different examples of annuities are there in the market. LIC policies are also considered under the annuities. Installment purchase. What? Installment purchase is also called as the, is also come under the category of annuity. Ata installment purchase manje kay? Ki tumhi, if you are taking the loan from bank for the car, you are paying the installment for that every month. Is it like that? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
That is also the series of equal payments made at the equal time interval. Yes, sir. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Even also, if you make the long-term bond, म्हणजे तुम्ही एखाद्या कंपनीला, if you are funding for some company, you have to make the contract there. Okay. And then company will also make you the equal payments. Understood? If you are given XYZ company 10 lakh rupees as a investment, mag equal series of equal payments tumhala karav lagtil ka company la karav lagtil? For example, Suraj has deposited or invested 10 lakh rupees in XYZ company. And for that, he has made the contract or the bond. Now, this series of equal payments has to be made by Suraj or this XYZ company.
Company
la Suraj la dyava lagtel na barobar na?
Yes sir.
Jasa tumhi loan geta tyaves tumhi bank la pay karta series of equal payments, pan jyaves tumhi swata ekadya company la funding karta tyaves ti company tumhala kay karel? Series of equal payments karel. That is also come under the annuity. Pension plans, pension also comes under the category of annuity. Pensions, some of your parents also must be, if you are having your grandparents there, they must be getting the pensions. Is there anybody whose grandparents parents are getting the pensions? Yes, pension hi kay bangade, pension manje kay?
रिटायर झाल्यावर भेटत सर ते मंथली.
मग कसं भेटत ते? त्याच्यासाठी काय करावं लागतं अगोदर? जे पेन जे कोणी एम्प्लॉय असतील बरोबर, त्यांना रिटायर झाल्यानंतर पेन्शन मिळत. पण ज्यावेळेस ते काम करत असतील त्यावेळेस त्यांच्या पेमेंट मधून काय होतं? काहीतरी अमाऊंट कट होत जाते बरोबर का?
यस सर.
आणि मग मग ते रिटायर झाल्यानंतर त्यांना त्याच अमाऊंट मधून थोडी थोडी अमाऊंट दिली जाते. सिरीज ऑफ इक्वल पेमेंट आर गिव्हन टू देम, करेक्ट?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So that thing also comes under the category of annuity. So some simple 2 marks question can be asked on the annuity, where you have to explain the definition and all these part with the examples, etc., etc. Okay, got this point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, still 1 point remaining from this unit. If you don't have any problem, we can continue for the next half hour, so that we can finish that last remaining topic also. Yes, all of you are ready for that? Or shall we stop? Yes, because it is already more than 1.5 hour. Okay, we are discussing the things. Okay, we'll continue that in the next lecture. Okay. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Only the last part is remaining. That is understanding the money management. That is also the simple one. We will see that in the next lecture. Okay, shall we stop here now?
Yes, sir.
Thank you, all of you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.